Good afternoon to everyone. A warm welcome to everyone for spending his precious time with me. Today our sponsors are about Velagapudi Ramakrishna Siddhartha Engineering College, Autonomous, Vijayawada, Vijayawada branch, Andhra Pradesh, coming to the department Electrical and Electronic Engineer. Today we have a great day. We are going to discuss about electrical vehicle design here. And next, coming to our convener of our department, Dr. P.V.R.L. Narasimhan, PhD, HOD of our department, Electrical and Electronic Engineer. Coming to the coordinator of our department, Dr. J. Ramesh, PhD, Associate Professor, and coming to the branch, Electrical and Electronic Engineer. Today we have a great day and we will go to discuss on electrical vehicle design here. Coming to this electrical vehicle design, before going to start our electrical vehicle design, we have to know some basics of power electronics. What is a power electronics components has a major efficient in this electrical vehicle here. Basically, what is a power electronics here? Coming to this initial classification, here what is a power? It is a cross product of voltage and current. Coming to this electronic, what is electronic meaning here? It will control the conversion of electrical power here. Next, coming to the electrical vehicle design, we have to know before going to start our electrical vehicle design, we have to know some basics of what is a electrical vehicle here and what are the application we are going to discuss with this electrical vehicle. And next, what are the working principle involved in this electrical vehicle and what are the types of this electrical vehicle, third one, and what are the comparisons while coming to discuss about this electrical vehicle, we have to know, and what are the battery, different types of battery used in this electrical vehicle, we have to know. And next, we have to know some major challenges about this electrification of electric vehicle. And next, we have to know some common feedback used in this electrical vehicle, we have to know here. Next, coming to next, we have to discuss something, various usage of this electrical vehicle, we have to know here. Coming to the first topic of this electrical vehicle, here what is electrical vehicle? Basically, here electrical vehicle is nothing but a vehicle which involves electrical motor which supplied to the battery. Here how we can say here, it receives some electricity from the plugging into the grid and stored in the form of battery. As we know, there is a continuous supply from grid to across the some household purpose, there will be a continued power supply. But if anything extra amount of power is not required, means it will store in the form of battery. That is the requirement of battery we will using here. Next, coming to the updated version, mostly in 2030 most of the vehicles are mostly preferring this hybrid vehicles only. Because why we are preferring this electrical vehicle? To avoid the pollution purpose, we are using here electrical vehicles. This is one of the main advantages of this electrical vehicle. Why we are preferring this electrical vehicle? It is coming to this electrical vehicle, we have some working principle. What is the working principle here? Here we have to know some basics of what is a motor and what is the difference between what is a generator. Coming to the motor conversion, what is the motor conversion involved in it? Here electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. While coming to this motor, what is the difference between generator? Here generator will convert mechanical energy into electrical energy. This is some of the difference between what is a motor and what is a generator here. Next, coming to this, there are some of the parts of electrical vehicles are battery. We can see here we can see some battery, and we will see some onboard charger, and we will see some transmission here, and we will see some charging port here. We can see here, and we will see some traction battery pack here, and as well as we will see some electrical traction motor, as well as we will see some electrical power electronics controller. I have said in previous while we are starting about this electrical vehicle, we have to know some basics of power electronics. I have said no here. Well, coming to this, power electronics mainly used to control the conversion of electrical purpose. We are using here electrical power electronics controller here. Next, in this, power electronics mainly concerned with transmission as well as processing the signal as well as data purpose. We are using here electrical power electronics components we are using in this electrical vehicle. Coming to this, there will be some converter. What is the use of this converter? Here, converter is nothing but an electrical device which convert unregulated DC values to regulated DC value, we can say here. Nothing but we can say here control is to convert the technique of DC to DC. We can say here. Again, we have some cooling system. Nothing but we can say here thermal system we have can say here. Next, there are some applications which are used in electrical vehicle, or we can say in detail, we can say here what is a battery here. Here battery is nothing but a power supply to electrical motor, and as well as the design of battery includes complex calculation with various parameters. We have to design this battery. In this battery, different types of techniques we are involved here. Coming to this power converter over here, basically what is a power converter here? Coming to this power converter, this electrical energy stored in the form of battery is fixed DC, we can say here. Where it is, it should be converted into variable DC. I have said now what is a converter here. Here converter will convert unregulated DC voltage to regulated DC voltage. We can say here how the conversion takes place here. It is mainly depend upon electrical motor as well as wheels, depend upon wheels and electrical motor, it will classified here in this power converter. Coming to this next, what is a electrical motor here? Here basically we have to know the conversion technique which are involved in this motor. The motor conversion will be electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. Coming to this, previously some induction motors are used in this electrical vehicle. Presently we are shifted towards electrical motor. Previously we are using some induction motors. Coming to the updated version, we will use here electrical motor. That is the main difference between previous vehicles and upcoming this updated version of these vehicles here. Next, coming to this clutch here, we will have to know some before going to design any electrical vehicle, we have to know some basics here. That's only I am going in detail with this electrical vehicle. Coming to this clutch, what is a clutch here? Here engine must be decoupled with the wheel to shift from low speed to high speed. That is the use of this clutch here. Coming to this transmission, what is a transmission here? Here the word transmission is involved because of power transfer from engine to wheel. That is the use of this transmission. It is also called as, we can say here, gearbox, we can say here. Coming to this drivetrain, what is a drivetrain here? It is a combination of, we can see here, it is a combination of electrical motor and clutch and gearbox. We can say here as drivetrain here. That is the use of this drivetrain. These are some of the inner components of this electrical vehicle here. We can see here what are the types used in this electrical vehicle, we are going to see here. Coming to, I have discussed in this before 2 minutes now, I have discussed previously we are using induction motor. Presently we are using here electrical motor here. Coming to this, what is a electrical motor here? An electrical motor is a device for converting electrical energy into mechanical energy in the form of rotation purpose. We are using here electrical motor here. Next, coming to this, how the motor works is a main problem here. How the motor works here, it is based on the principle that which a current carrying conductor is placed in the form of magnetic field, it will experience some mechanical force whose direction is given by Fleming's left hand rule. By using this Fleming's left hand rule, we can start the how the motor works here means by using some Fleming left hand rule, we will start the motor here by using it has some magnitude. Next, coming to this, some of the parts of simple electrical motor which are involved in this motor is we have some armature rotor, and we will have some commutator, we will have some brushes, and we will have some axle. And coming to this, we will have some field magnet, and we will have some DC power supply. These are some of the parts of electrical motor here. Coming to this, there are some charts of all electrical motors are here. Basically, electrical motors are classified into two types here. Two types of classification are AC motors and DC motors here. Further, these AC motors are classified into this induction motor and synchronous motor. Coming to these DC motors, they are classified into separately excited and self-excited machine here. Coming to this induction motor, we are classified into single phase motor and three phase motor. This explanation I will go through practical manner while we are designing this electrical motor. I will show in detail while going through this MATLAB. I will show some simulation diagram where it is parallel to it here. Coming to these self-excited, they are classified into series excited and shunt excited and compound excited here. Coming to this introduction, some introduction of electrical motor here. Some introduction of electrical motor. We have some electrical cars are mostly preferred into electric automobiles, which are preferred by electrical engine and electrical energy. These are about electrical cars here. Mostly we are preferring this electrical vehicle. No, we have to discuss here. Next, there are some development of electrical vehicles is very perceptive and important process purpose we are using here electrical vehicles here. Next, in these electrical vehicles are the vehicle they are powered through the electrical motor instead of using some internal combustion engine here. Basically, we are using some for any electrical car we are using. Basically, we are using some cars, no? We are, for these cars, we are taking some petrol and engine, no? Instead of avoiding the pollution purpose, we are mostly preferring here electrical vehicles. We are mostly preferring in this generation here. Mainly to avoid the pollution, mainly to reduce the cost purpose, we are mostly preferring this electrical vehicle. Next, coming to the next slide. There are some history regarding with this electrical vehicle. The history of electrical vehicle began with the midterm of 19th century. In 1832, there will be a robot Einstein invites here non-rechargeable electrical carriage here. Coming to this 1835, there are some invention invented by Thomas and Davenport builds the first practical electrical vehicle. Coming to in 1976, there are some general electrical vehicles which are chosen in the construction of parallel hybrid sedan, and Toyota built it is a first hybrid car which are introduced in 1976 here. First hybrid car is introduced in 1976, you can remember here. Coming to this, why we need this electrical vehicle? It is a main question mark here. Why we need here electrical vehicle? While we are using some cars, no? You are using some petrol and diesel, no? Why we are preferring this electrical vehicle is a main task here. In order to avoid the pollution and in order to use some non-conversion fuel here, mainly to it is cheaper to maintain here while coming to this electrical vehicle. If you are initially the charging stations of while you are starting any electrical vehicle, means we have to have some charging stations here. While what is the charging stations here? If you are initially placing in one to 10 charging station, means initially the cost of this electrical vehicle for charging purpose is somewhat heavy. If you are placing here multiple charging stations in different locations, the cost will be something low here. Initially the cost will be heavy, and while coming to the multiple charging stations or multiple vehicles are using here, we want some multiple charging stations, and by using some multiple charging stations we can reduce the cost here. That is the use of why we are preferring this electrical vehicle here. Coming to this, there will be a cost will be something low here while we are using this electrical vehicle. While coming to the next slide, there are some benefits of electrical vehicle. What are the benefits of this electrical vehicle? There will be energy efficient, as well as we will have some reduced energy dependence, as well as we will have some regenerative braking. I will say the in-depth of what is in regenerative braking, and there will be something benefits of this electrical vehicle. It is easy to make autonomous vehicle, as well as there will be a easy of driving here while we are preferring this electrical vehicle, and there will be pollution free here. It is one of the more advantages of this previous vehicles and these vehicles here. While coming to this next slide, there are some components of electrical vehicle here. There will be some motor, and there will be some controller, and there will be some charger, and there will be some DC to DC converter, and there will be some contactors and batteries here. I say no, what is about battery? Here battery is nothing but a power supply to electrical motor, as it is designed with some complex calculation with various parameters. This is about something about battery here. While coming to this regenerative braking, I have said no. Here we can see some regenerative braking. What is a here regenerative braking here? It is nothing but a amount of energy consumed by the braking purpose we are using here, regenerative. Main purpose of this regenerative braking is for energy lost is shown in the form of battery here. That is why we are preferring here regenerative braking here. that is the use of some regenerative braking here. And the units of this regenerative braking is kilowatt per hour here. This is something information about this regenerative braking here. And coming to the next slide, there are some components we have discussed now. There will be motor, controller, charger, and DC to DC converter, and contactors, and there will be a contactors and battery here. Next, coming to the next slide here, there are most commonly used in these electrical vehicles are DC series motor and BLDC. BLDC series motor and induction motor, permanent magnet synchronous motor, SRM. What is a SRM here? Basically, here SRM is nothing but we can call switched reluctance motor purpose. These are different type of motors most commonly used in this electrical vehicle here. Coming to the next slide here. Coming to the next slide, there will be something information about motor here. Basically, we are using here brushless DC motor is used in this generation, present update version. And if any signal problem means you can give chart me as a reply. If any signal problem, you can say me as a message here. I will do and I will rectify it. If any signal problem is there means you can message in the form of chart here. While coming to this is something information about motor and what is the motor conversion here. Here electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. This is something information about motor. Coming to this, this is some of the circuit diagram of induction motor here, and we will go through here and we will go through some simulation also here. You will get clarity information about this circuit diagram of induction motor. If any signal problem means you can say in the form of chart here. I will rectify it. I will rectify in the form of within a short time here. Okay, sir. Thanks for your chart, bro. Yamini, AAA department. Good session. Okay, bro. Okay, thank you, bro. Thanks for your compliments. And next, there is some controller here. Here, what is a controller here? Controller is to control the BLDC motor and mainly to increase the efficiency and reliability and for extending of battery lifespan, we are using some controller period here. This is something information about controller here. And coming to the charger, what is a charger here? It contains a plug that connects electrical vehicle to the battery to an electrical source providing the battery with electrical energy here. It is something information about battery here. It contains a plug that connects to the electrical vehicle battery to an electrical source providing a batteries with the help of some electrical energy. This is something information about charger here. Next, coming to the what are the types of charging and what are the different types of charging station we have to know here. Basically, in different types of charging stations, sir, we will use here 120 volts and 240 volts and 440 volts. These are some of the different kind of voltages, different kind of charging stations here. We have to know basically while coming to these types of charger, there will be a level 1 and level 2. While coming to this level 1, they have some power charging here. Power at level 1, we have some 120 volts here. And for 120 volts, we will have some 1.4 kilowatt. And current will be 12 amps here. While coming to this another level 1 of 120 volts, there will be a 1.9 kilowatt. And there will be a current of 16 amperes here. This is something about this level 1. Coming to this level 2 of power, we'll have some 240 volts here. It will drive up to 19.2 kilowatts. We will say how much current drag is. Here current drag will be 80 amperes here. Here there will be a level 1 charging time will be 3 to 5 milliamps, 5 miles here. While coming to the level 2 of charging time, there will be a 3.3 kilowatt to and there are how much miles here means for 3.3 kilowatts, there will be up to 10 to 14 miles here. While coming to this 6.6 kilowatts, we will have some 20 to 25 miles here. And while coming to this 9.6 kilowatts, we will have some 40 to 45 miles. And while coming to this 19.2 kilowatts, we will have up to 16 miles here. This is something information about charging time here. It is charging time. We will have some miles of range per hour of charge here. While coming to this DC fast charging, we will have some public and large feed use here. This is, I think it's not wanted here. Main purpose of these types of charges to increase the cost and complexity tends to increase the faster level of charging level. That's why only we are preferring this this level 1 and level 2 charging here. While coming to this, have said now there were the different types of charging here. There will be at 120 volts, and as well as we will have some 204 to 240 volts here. And while coming to DC fast charging, we will have some 480 volts here. While what time for level 1 charger? For level 1 charger, we have some specific time here. While coming to this specific time, we will have for 120 volts, we have to charge. Time is about 6 to 10 hours here. And for the level 2, we have some power capability of 204 to 240 volts here. The time required for this level 2 is 1 hour to 3 hours, it is required. While coming to this DC fast charging for 480 volts, we required only 30 minutes. We can see the difference between above time and below time here. For a DC fast charging, we will have some time requirement will be something less here. As we are using here, time requirement is something less means we can avoid the electricity bill charge also. It is one of the advantage only for DC fast charging purpose here. Here we can see it is best for the highway seats to enable long vehicle trips here. This is one of the advantage here for a DC charge fast charging battery here. While coming to this level 2, we have some commercial use and we work vehicles that are heavily used and need of a medium charge purpose, we are using here level 2. And while coming to this level 1, we have some long-term parking at a commutator, lots of vehicles parked at overnight here. This is some of the advantages here. While coming to the next slide here, there are some DC to DC converter. Here basically what is a DC to DC converter here? Here I have said no, to convert unregulated DC voltage to regulated DC voltage. Nothing but we can say if any disturbance occur in the this converter, we can rectify it by using some converter here. This is the why we are preferring this DC to DC converter means this is one of the advantage here. And as well as we will have some recharge to recharge the battery through the DC converter, and we will have some data of DLS-55 is most commonly option we are using in this IoT data. Here IoT is nothing but internet of charging here. And the different kind of batteries used for the electrical vehicle. What are the batteries here? The batteries that are used for electrical charge, electrical cars and rechargeable purpose, we are using here batteries here. We can see some of the diagram of this battery here, inner port of this electrical vehicle here. These are some of the batteries used in this electrical vehicle, mainly for recharging purpose. We can see here some of the batteries here. These are some controllers here. There will come up for the control of a battery. We'll have some flow of electrons can be reversed through reload, and there will be a negative electrode to make the battery rechargeable. This is something information about this control of this electrical vehicle. We can see here a motion battery here, and we'll see here some maintenance of pre battery here, block diagram here. Here batteries have some different techniques here. Based on the battery only, we will have some survivor of this electrical vehicle. Main purpose of while we have to have some good efficiency while we are using any battery here. While coming to some introduction of a battery here, what is a battery here? Here battery is a electrical device which stored in the form of energy, in the form of chemical energy is converted into electrical output here. This is something information of a battery, and battery has some high energy density, but there will be a low power density here. It will convert high energy density into low power density here for getting high energy number of cells are connected in the form of battery here. we are using different kind of battery. I say no, we are using here example, we can say here lead acid battery and lithium ion battery. Here we are using, while we are designing here any electrical vehicle, means we are mostly we are preferring here lead acid battery and lithium ion battery. Here type of batteries, here we can see here which what are the types of batteries. Here there will be a rechargeable battery and there will be a non rechargeable battery. Coming to this rechargeable battery, what is a rechargeable battery? This is a type of battery, it can be used again and again purpose for charging. Here this is called as rechargeable battery. The cells operate near to the equilibrium and the reaction will be reversible. You can say here some examples of this rechargeable battery and lead acid battery and lithium ion battery. Coming to this non rechargeable battery, the types of cells can be used to get the energy from only one time only. Only for a non rechargeable battery will have through only go through only one time. Here the cells work on the spontaneous form of reaction here. And some examples of non rechargeable battery are dry cells, alkaline cells and lithium boron battery. Here we are some of the non rechargeable battery. Here most commonly used battery, what is the most commonly used battery? For portable device, dry cells are used initially and lead acid battery used in the form of this electrical vehicle, and lithium ion battery used in the form of portable electronics such as we will use in the form of laptops and smartphone purpose. We are using this battery chargeable. You can see some of the diagram of this battery here, sorry, and we can see some inner parameters of this lead acid battery. What is a lead acid battery? Here we'll see some specification involved in this lead acid batteries. We'll have some specific energy as 33 to 42 wattage per kg, and for a power we will have some 180 wattage by kg. And while coming to this charge and discharge efficiency, there will be 50 to 95%, and for a self discharge rate we will have some 3 to 20% of per month, and for a cycle durability will be less than 350 cycles here. And coming to this normal cell voltage, we will have some 2.1 voltage here. This is something information in specifications used in this lead acid battery here. Coming to the specifications of lithium ion battery, which are using in this in the form of smart battery, will have some specific energy. Have specific energy 100 to 265. While coming to this power, wattage by kg, we will have some 250 to 340 here. While coming to charging and discharging efficiency, we will have some 90% efficiency here. While we are using this lithium ion, while coming to this cycle duration, there will be a 400 to 1200 cycles here. While coming to this nominal cell voltage, we will have some 3.6 to 3.85 voltage here. Lifespan will be something heavy here while we are using this lithium ion space here. This is something information about lead acid and lithium specification here. Next, in this electrical vehicle, we are using some battery banking. What is the battery banking here? Main purpose of this battery banking is for amount of energy stored which is needed in the form of number of batteries here. For the purpose of better batteries, we are connecting here in series and parallel, and for series connection, the voltage of battery bank is increasing here, and parallel current also increasing here. That is the use of this series connection. While coming to this battery bank, we will have some battery management system here for lifespan, for efficiency purpose, and as well as lifespan of this electrical vehicle purpose, we are using some battery banks to get efficiency will be high here. These are some of the different kind of series connection as well as parallel connection here. We can see here some of the comparison of hybrid electrical vehicle controlling strategy here. In this, while coming to this classification comparison of hybrid electrical vehicle, we have to know something information about classification of hybrid electrical vehicle. While coming to this classification, are mainly classified into based on architecture and as well as degree of hybridization. What is here basically, what is based on architecture and degree of hybridization? I will say no, in the interior part of this architecture, we will have some charging depletion as well as charging substation here. Daddy. Wait for a minute. This is something information about this classification of hybrid electrical vehicle. It is classified into based on architecture as well as degree of hybridization here. It is mainly depend upon charging depletion as well as charging substation here. It is mainly to produce electricity purpose only. We are using here charging depletion as well as charging substation here. While coming to this strategy of this electrical peaking hybrid concept here, we will use we have to know some what is the difference between motor and generator. I have previously discussed it before 10 minutes, I think so. And we will have some, there will be advantages of this electrical hybrid vehicle. The chip will be have some high speed and reduces emission and optimizes the fuel economy purpose. So this is one of the advantage, and the performance of this electrical vehicle also increase here. While we are using some special kind of batteries here, while coming to this disadvantage, the power provided by the battery is significant, require more batteries, thus have more weight. This is some of the disadvantages. Initially the cost will be high, and while we are going through multiple, in the cost will be something low here. This is something information about a hybrid electrical vehicle here. While coming to this, there are some fuzzy logic control here. This is there are some advantages of this fuzzy logic control areas. SOC in limits here. What is SOC? Here SOC is nothing but a state of charge, we can say here. I will show in simulation diagram while going through, and there will be a measurements for this tolerant as well as variability of this component. These are some of the advantages. And coming to these disadvantages, there will be a high fuel consumption here in this fuzzy logic controller because of IC chip is operated at high torque region here. Coming to this advantages, what are the advantages using in this hybrid electrical vehicle? There are some advantages mainly to pollution avoiding purpose we are using while we are most preferring this electrical vehicle. And we will have some recycling batteries here, and we will have some no fire hedges, hard rats here for low maintenance, as well as cost of operation will be low here. These are some of the advantages. Coming to these disadvantages, the price will be high here while going through heavy batteries, and Tesla model cost around 50,000 here. While going through this, rechargeable time will be something time heavy, as your battery using in a good time, there will be something efficiency more here. The next, coming to this, range will be 20 to 30 miles here. These are some of the disadvantages. I will go through the simulation diagram while completing this. After completing, this is some of the hybrid vehicle, how hybrid vehicle is updated in this version here. There will be some charging battery charger, there will be a high voltage battery, and there will be a connection of high voltage battery to this bidirectional converter, and we will have some DC to DC converter, and we will have some annexity loads here, and there will be an inverter between bidirectional converter and electrical motor here. And I will go through, while going through this simulation diagram, you get something idea about this. And there will be a torque to drive the wheels here. I said before, no, this information we have, I said clear information about this in previous slides. While going to the next slide here, I will go through some simulation diagram here. This is something information about electrical vehicle here. Afterwards, I will conclude here. Simulating model here. After going through this simulating model, we'll have some blank model. By dragging all the components, we'll do the simulation here. I started MATLAB doing simulink model. I think there will be a connection problem here. If any connection problem is, you can chat in the form of message here. I will rectify it, and will within a short period I will rectify it. While going through this simulation diagram, I think there will be something internet problem. That's only it's disconnected. I'm starting again. I am taking as input source as household purpose. I am taking here 230 volts here. 230 volts purpose. I am taking here AC voltage source here. For a 230 volt household purpose, I am taking here one of the AC voltage source here. For AC volt purpose, I am going through this SimScape. Library is classified into two types, SimScape and Simlink here. While going through this, we'll have some power system, specialized technology, fundamental blocks, this electrical sources. From this electrical source, I am drawing here one AC voltage source. From this, I am taking to convert this AC to DC, I am taking here a rectifier. For rectifier purpose, I am taking here one diodes here. For diode purpose, I am going to this power electronics. This I am taking here four diodes. From these diodes, I am taking here one R load here. For load or R load purpose, I am going through these elements here. From these elements, series RLC branch I am going through. And next I am going through one capacitor I want here. That's only I am taking here another one series RLC branch here. Next afterwards I want one voltage measurement as well as one scope for measuring the voltage here. For measuring the voltage, I am going through these measurements here, block, voltage measurements. I am going through one scope here for seeing the output voltage here. For scope purpose, I am going through this most commonly used block. Scope I am taking here. I am doing something connection here. After doing connection, we can see. I am placing in a systematic manner here. Initially, I am taking household purpose. I am taking here as 230 volts. And for converting this into DC, I am using as a rectifier here. Here, rectifier will convert AC to DC now. I am connecting here multiply. You can drag, I want four diodes here. That's only I am dragging here. Or else you can queue copy paste here. I am taking here four diodes and this positive terminal is connected to this diode positive. Same, the positive is connected to this positive and negative of this diode is connected to this positive and negative of this diode is connected to this positive and negative of this diode is connected to this reference line here. And negative of this diode is connected to this reference line here. I am keeping parallelly here. I am taking one capacitor here. I think there is something internet problem. That's only it is stuck in previous here. I am taking here one R load here. Previously I have having something disturbance. It is due to internet connection. Or else it won't be happen. This negative is connected to this ground terminal and we will connect this resistor negative this to ground terminal and this positive resistor is connected to this diode positive and to measure the voltage here we have to connect here positive terminal to this positive and negative is connected to this to ground here and to measure the voltage we have to connect these two directly to this scope here parallelly. I am taking one diode here. Just I am giving this input AC voltage as 230 volts here and frequency according to India hertz. I am taking here 50 hertz here. And next I am giving this, I am rotating here according through a simulation diagram I have shown in this PPT slide. According to this only I am going through here. I am doing simulation diagram related to here. Simulation diagram related to according to this circuit diagram induction motor I have said now. According to this only I am doing here parallel simulation diagram here. I am taking input sources as a AC and converting into DC here by using some rectifier here. I am connecting them parallelly. I am connecting here three phase inverter here. I am giving connection to this BLDC induction motor here. We can use induction motor or else BLDC motor according to our convenience. In this simulation diagram, I am going through this induction motor. Previously, it is having a diagram with a three-phase BLDC motor. Now, I am going through three-phase induction motor. Here, induction motor also called as asynchronous motor, we can say here. While going through this simulation, I am rotating here. I am taking for how the battery is charging. I will show here. And this negative is connected to here positive. How the battery is charging, I will show. I will taking one battery here. For a battery, I am going through this. The battery is available in here Simscape, power system, specialized technology, electrical drive. We in this extra sources, we will have in some battery. We have to connect here. We have to add the block into the model. Here battery I have placing in a downside here. How the battery is charging, we will go through it. And next I am taking unwanted again one diode here. This positive is connected to this positive. And this the positive terminal is connected to this battery here. And negative is connected to this. I will take another three phase inverter. I will say here, after taking three phase inverter, it is converted into here. I am taking one inverter here. Inverter is the electrical device which convert AC to DC here. Initially, I am taking here input source as household purpose. I am taking no. For charging purpose, I am taking as a input source as 230 volts here. I am converting this into rectifier, nothing but AC to DC, and I will convert this by how the battery is charging. We will go through it, and we will connect these to some three-phase inverter. I will show here. After connecting this three-phase inverter, this negative is connected to this port here, and negative is connected to this reference terminal here, and this input is connected to some unwanted to in this battery. We are using here lithium ion battery here. Next I am taking one most commonly used block, one bus selector to remove all the unwanted signal purpose. I am taking here. I am connecting this battery to this import, this import to this signal bus selector. Once double clicking this bus selector to remove, we can remove all the unwanted signals, and we can place what are the signals we will want here. We can see I am removing these unwanted signals here, and I am selecting here a state of charge, nothing but a select state of charge. SOC is nothing but we can measure here current measurement, also we can measure also here voltage measurements. Apply. Okay, next we are having three. You can see here three ports here. How to measure here? You can see output voltage here. That's only I'm taking here. This first port is connected to this first scope, and the second port is connected to this second scope. I'm taking one more scope here, and third port is connected to this third scope. We can see here something. Waveform very clearly. Purpose, I am taking individual scopes here. We can measure in only one scope. We can't see very clearly. That's only I am going through multiple scopes here. And next I will go through this inverter. I said no. For this three-phase inverter, initially three-phase inverter is same thing as inverter. In this, what is the difference between means? That in the single-phase inverter, there will be some unbalanced system. To rectify it, we are using here three-phase inverter here. We will go through this for three phase inverter. Input source is that DC, no? That input source is DC, and further it is converted into AC here. I am going through this power electronics. I am going through switches purpose. I am taking here MOSFET switches. I am going preferring through. I want here for device designing here three phase inverter. I want here six switches here. I am placing here six switches here. I am rotating here, and I want six more. I can drag here or else copy paste here, or we can do like this also. Here we can see the connection, how the connection will be. The source is connected to this drain. There will be some internal diagrams here, internal values here. I will show after connecting it.
have to place in a systematic manner here. And this gate terminal drain is connected to this positive terminal here. I am connecting this gate to this positive of this diode here, and I am connecting here negative terminal to this battery here. Here positive and negative I am connected, and parallel I am connecting here source to this reference line here, nothing but a negative value. Drain is connected to this positive. The connection is something mismatched, that's why it's not connecting. I have to connect in a systematic manner. I have said no. I am connecting this drain to this terminal, and this it will connect. You can see here. It will connect automatically. If any mistake means it will not connect, it will show as a red line here. For the series inverter, I have taken here pulse generator. Why I am taking here pulse generator means to control the switch purpose. I am taking here pulse generator. The pulse generator is available in the sources here. Here we can see pulse generator, and we will take here voltage measurement purpose. I am taking one voltage measurement voltage here. The voltage measurement is available in this measurements. Most commonly used block scope, or else we can take here one display also to see the output voltage very clearly. Next, afterwards I am selecting here one pulse generator I have to take here. The pulse generator is available in the source here. Here we have to take here 2-6 pulse generator, because we have in here 6 switches now. Here we can see here 6 pulse generator I am taking here. Each pulse generator is connected to this gate terminal. Generally MOSFET is a 3 terminal device. Here gate drain source. Here drain terminal is connected to positive, and the source is connected to negative, and gate terminal is connected to this pulse generator here initially. And this gate terminal is connected to this pulse generator. Initially, after connecting here, I am connecting one to check the all the unwanted signal purpose. Wait for a minute. To measure the voltage, I am purpose. I am taking here voltage measurement, and next I am taking here one motor here. We have a motor taking as a synchronous motion here. A synchronous motor is available in this specialized technology machines. From these machines I am taking here permanent magnet synchronous generator to convert. What is the use of this permanent magnet synchronous machine here? To convert mechanical energy into electrical energy purpose. I am taking here a permanent magnet synchronous machine here. Here we can see I am taking here one constant block, and this A port is connected to this A terminal, and B port is connected to this leg here. I will say the connection diagram. After connecting it, C port is connected here, and for a east pulse generator there will be a switching pattern here: S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. Here we can see here. If any having any questions means, you can arise here in the form of chart here parallelly. If any connection problem, you can ask me in the form of chart here parallelly. I will rectify it. Next, I am connecting, I am giving a pulse. How the switching pattern will be, you can see here: S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. For a east gate, there will be a pulse generator to control the switch here. There will be some inner parameters. The parameters will be amplitude, time period, pulse width, and phase delay. Coming to this, amplitude will be taken as a constant. That's why I am taking here one value. There will be a time period formula. 1 by frequency, the frequency value I am taking as 50, 1 by 50 value is 0.02. And generally I am preferring here 180 mode here. 180 mode I am preferring here. What is the formula? This pulse width means the degree which you are using. Presently I am using here 180 degree mode. Total angle will be 360 into 100, nothing but 180 by 360 into 100. 1 by 2 into 100, nothing but we can say here 50% here. The value is shown in the form of, the formula will be time period by number of switches into way which switching position here. The switching position will be how, like means, the switching position will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see here switching position at 0 now. That's only I am taking here 0 position. For 0 into something value is 0 now. That's only I am preferring like this. And next I am giving connection as supply. Okay, this is something about switch 1. Coming to the switch 2, there will be some parameters here now. How to conclude the parameters here? Time period 0.02. I have said the formula now. I am preferring here 180 degree mode. Total angle 360 into 100. 180 by 360 into 100. 1 by 2 into 100. 50%, you can see. Coming to this phase delay. What is the phase delay formula? Time period by number of switches and to switch position. Switch position at switch 2, what is it? It will be a switch position will be 1 here. Here, what is the value of this 0.02 by 6 here? 3.3 E minus 3. You can calculate in the form of, you can calculate in CalC if you have in if you have nearby you. Into 1 here. You can see here into 1 I am preferring. Into 1. The value will be same for all. That's only I am taking this copying here. Next, coming to this, the phase position will be 1 here. You can 1. Okay. Next, coming to this S3 switch, the position will be 2 here. The values will be 0.02. 50 is up. I have set a formula now, 50%. Only the switch position will be changed. That's all are same here. Switch position into 2. I think it's okay for you. If any having how you are taking values are means, you can chart in the form of group in chart here. You can message here. Okay. Next, coming to this S3, I hover now. S4. There will be a switch. There will be a position will be 3 here. Here position will be 2 now. The position will be 3 here. All the values are same here. The position will be 50. Only position changes only. All are equal here. Into 3 here position. Coming to this SY switch. There will be inner parameters here. 0.02. 50. The position will be into 4 here. Coming to the S6 switch. S6 switch, where will the position? You can see here. Coming to this S6 switch, the position will be 5 here. The value will be 0.02. 50. Position 5 here. You can see here. Okay. I am giving for this electrical torque, I am taking one constant value here. constant value I am taking is 1 here, constant block. I am preferring here a constant and constant block. I am giving that value as 1 here, and directly I am connecting this constant block to this electrical torque here, and this I am connecting these two to remove all the unwanted signals of this permanent magnet synchronous machine. I am selecting here one bus selector here. Next I am selecting, I am connecting these four to this bus selector. I am removing all the unwanted signals. I am selecting, I want to have some measurements of this rotor speed and how the stator current I want to measure here. I am selecting here, we can select any value also here. I am selecting here stator current. Stator current select. It is came into right side. And I want to measure here one stator current here. Stator current and rotor speed I have to measure here. Rotor speed I want to measure here. That's all I am selecting here. Apply. Okay. It is directly, it is shown now. After connecting individual scope, we can measure here. That's only I am taking here one gain terminal here. Gain block here. And that gain block is available in here only. Most commonly used block. I am connecting this gain block to this terminal here. To remove all the somewhat unwanted signals. Purpose I am removing here. I am selecting here and I am selecting this port to here and I am connecting due to one scope here. To measure the voltage here and for this rotor speed I am taking another one scope here. I am taking another scope here to measure rotor speed here. Rotor speed is connected to the scope. I am removing all the unwanted signals here. We can see how the output voltage will be. I am taking one power zero block here to waveform will for continuity purpose. I am taking one power zero. The power zero block is available in this specialized technology SIM blocks. You can see here. I am placing in a top manner. Here. There will be some connections here. After connecting here, how the battery is charging, we can see very clearly here. How the battery waveform will be, we can see here. After running the simulation, there will be something you can see a difference here. I am running the simulation here. If any errors means it will show automatically. If any errors are not available, it will show directly as a result here. I am displaying the signal what have showed in this here we can see the output waveform here. After running the simulation, we can see the output of the simulation here. If you are having any doubts, means you can reply in the form of chat. I will give the answers for you. Anyone. I think it will take something up to 40 seconds here. You can give something. You can ask me any questions if you have any doubts here. The signals are generated, you can observe here. How the signals are generated here, you can observe after running the simulation. Here we can see how the signals are generated. We can see here. I am taking. If you are having any doubts, friends, you can ask in the form of chat here. I will give reply for you. Anyone also having any doubts, friends, you can chat in the group here. Having any doubts, friends, you can ask me. I am reading your comment boxes. If you have any doubts, friends, you can message me in the form of chat here. After completion of here 100%, we can see the output waveform here. We can see the output waveform of state of charge and output measurement, current measurement of this, how the battery is charging. We can see here, and we'll give something inner parameters of this battery here. We can change the battery parameters also inside. There will be something values will be changed here. We can see the variation of previous result and this result here. After running this 100%, we can see the output waveform very clearly. If any doubts having you, means you can chat in the form of you can chat me in the message box, in the live box you can chat me. I will give the answers for you. If any doubts has you, means you can chat for me, chat with me. Someone asked Sirish Reddy, what are the parts of electrical vehicle? We are using here battery and converter, and we will use some clutch here, and we will use main parts. We are going to discuss here means battery and DC to DC converter here, and we will go through this clutch here. We will go through some transmission line. What is a gearbox here? I have said previous. No, these are some of the parts of this electrical vehicle here. Sirish Reddy, okay, fine. Next, coming to anyone asking, if anyone having doubts, means you can ask me. I will reply in this manner. Jagan, team Jagan, is it SMPS or no, sir? It is not SMPS. Switch mode power supply. Switch mode power supply, sir. In this electrical vehicle, we have some plugging system. As we are going through this updated version, we will have some. We will not use some diesel and petrol. We will directly use some plugging system, and we will charge the battery. And we will charge the battery. After charging the battery, you can utilize for your needs here. This is what I want to say here. Coming to this, we can see the output waveform here. After connecting this AC voltage source, here we can see very clearly. After pressing this plus symbol, we can see very clearly how the battery's output waveform of this rectifier. We can see here, we can see the output waveform from these tools. I am zooming here, zoom x axis here. Here we can see output waveform of this something rectifier. Here we can change the value initially here. battery parameters I am changing here. I am giving here nominal voltage as 150 here to charge the battery. I am giving here initial start state of charge is 40. I am giving as a way to value has to be started. I am giving here value as 40 here. I am running the simulation here. After running the simulation, we can give something neat waveform here. How the battery is charging, we can go through it. We can take here instead of taking here permanent magnet synchronization, you can take here directly as induction motor here. Induction motor also we can take here to convert the conversion purpose. We will take here induction motor, or else we will take any motor based on our convenient here. I am increasing this resistor value up to 100 here. Resistor value. I am just changing the value of that resistor. I am increasing the value to get a pure rectifier value. Rectifier output I have to see now. I am giving something load across this diode here. You can ask me any questions having you doubt. Previously we are using your induction motor. Presently we are going to this electrical vehicle. Now we are preparing here electrical motor here. Here we can see. After running the simulation, we can see it is taking time due to the time given has 10 now. That's only it is taking something time here, or else the waveform are very clear. I am showing the output waveform of this simulation file. Here we can see the how the battery is charging. We can see here the simulation is completed. I will show the how the battery is charging here. Here we can see I am connecting directly this. How the state of charge it is increasing, you can see here. How the current value is increasing, we can see here. Here we can see the current value. Initially, when the battery is charging, it will start from negative value here. Here we can see the output value here. If the battery is charging, the current starts from negative value here. These are some of the output here. And we can see in the output of this synchronous machine, output we can see how the rotor speed will be. Now the rotor speed will be, you can see, observe here. How it is increasing, you can observe here. Here we can see from the way the value is starting is the initial point here. It is starting from, basically it is starting from 1500 here. And basically it is constant up to 1480. It is constant value we can observe here. And coming to this stator current, we can see how the waveform will be. How the stator current output will be. You can see, observe here. After connecting this, we can measure here output waveform of this rectifier also. We can see here. You can see how the waveform of this rectifier, as we are giving something load across this rectifier now. We can see the output waveform also here. How the waveform of this rectifier here. These are some of the output waveform I want to show here. This is something information about electrical vehicle design. I hope you have enjoyed the session here. This is how I want to explain today. I hope you clear about this session. If you have any doubt, we'll give reply in the form of chat. Here we can see how the output waveform will be. How the battery is charging, we can see here by connecting initially as a AC voltage source as 230 volts, and by using some rectifier, it will connect AC to DC, and by using some three-phase inverter, it is connecting again into DC into AC, and I am using some motor here too, and by using this motor, in the induction motor, I am seeing here induction motor also called as asynchronous machine here. I am seeing some output waveform here, stator current output waveform, and as well as rotor speed output waveform we can see here. You can see here the output waveform, stator and rotor speed here. This is how battery is charging here. We can see here output waveform of rectifier here. This is how I want to conclude here. I hope the session is enjoyed by you. Thanks for spending precious time with me. These are some advantages and disadvantages. Coming to this basic simulation of log diagram, I have explained now. After completion of this, these are some of the parameters used in this while we are designing this electrical vehicle. And I want to thanks for Velagapudi Ramakrishna Siddhartha Engineering College. Thanks for giving me this opportunity to spend a precious time with my friends. It has a great day about this webinar on electrical vehicle design. Thanks for convener of our college, Dr. P.V. R.L. Narasimhan, PhD, HOD sir. Narasimhan sir, PhD, HOD department, HOD electrical department. Coming to this coordinator, Dr. J. Ramesh, PhD, associate professor, electrical and electronic engineering. I want to thank, Srinivasan sir and Kumaraswamy sir and Sintal sir, thanks for giving this opportunity. I hope the session is enjoyed by you. Thanks for all. from this I am ending the session here. See here output waveform of rectifier here. This is how I want to conclude here. I hope the session is enjoyed by you. Thanks for spending precious time with me. These are some advantages and disadvantages coming to this basic simulation of log diagram. I have explained now. After completion of this, these are some of the parameters used in this while we are designing this electrical vehicle. And I want to thank you. I want to thanks for the engineering college. Thanks for giving me this opportunity to spend a precious time with me, with my friends. It has a great day about this webinar and let up for college and Dr. P.V. R.L. Narasimhan, PhD. HOD sir, maximum sir, PhD, HOD department, HOD electrical department. Coming to this coordinator, Dr. J. Ramesh, PhD, associate professor, electrical and electronic engineer. I want to thank, next I want to thank Srinivasan sir and Kumaraswamy sir and Sitar sir. Thanks for giving this opportunity. I hope the session is enjoyed by you. Thanks for all. From this, I am ending the session here.